What's happening, folks? Back with another reaction, back with some more Freiheit. And we're going back to the 1987 album Romancing in the Dark. And we're up to the tune Stay Cool or Play It Cool, which are, you know, those are sort of two different directives or requests or normative suggestions, prescriptive perhaps. But yeah, the idea of to play it cool means to sort of, you know, have a poker face, so to speak. The idea of not really betraying your intentions or tipping your hand, revealing your plan. The idea of just, you know, play it cool, don't make a big motion either way, just kind of wait for the right moment, at which point, you know, you can play your role or execute your part. So play it cool, and, you know, maybe in the context of some, you know, entertainment, movies, TV shows, it relates to people who are, you know, at least up to mischief, if not sort of, you know, trying to do something where they have to deceive others, whether in an official capacity or otherwise. So the idea of playing it cool in that context would be, you know, don't blow your cover, don't do something that sort of reveals that you're not who we're saying you are. So play it cool. There's a maybe a sense of like tension or danger to it. So yeah, it makes me think about a number of different possibilities, but ultimately the idea of not revealing what is actually at hand is what feels to me the essence of the phrase, even if it is sort of a directive just to, you know, not make a big motion or not make waves. Ultimately, it feels like there's more to the story if, you know, that is the directive that's being given. So we'll figure out what it is, but let's get it. This is Freiheit. The tune is Play It Cool, and it's from the 1987 album Romancing in the Dark.
Oh, you, though I see you can't hide your tears.
Feels like a Boys to Men tune. Or maybe Queen.
Guess I always have to be your fool. Better break it up and play it cool. There's something wrong, something has gone, and your eyes are cold and lonely. Tears from no one sitting next to you. I feel the way you do. So is it any wonder we realize the moon is turning on? Sweet dreams in vain. But who's to blame? I remember love was easy, and forever, that was long ago. Oh, how was I to know? You took all my affection and gave it to a dozen Romeos. Oh,
that like sitar like transitional little bit.
You don't need no explanations, no excuses. So look me in the eye, cause you don't have to lie. I wanna hear you tell me that starting out again's not worth a try. Oh, you
for another. It feels like sort of like a radio edit, or like a single edit. Nevertheless, it's a cool tune. It feels like a, you know, romantic ballad. It feels kind of like a slow dance song from the 80s, a song that, you know, you play later in the evening when it's time for couples to sort of, you know, start leaning on each other's shoulder and the like. But yeah, ultimately, if I was reading that right, it sounds like someone who, like, is there to sort of be a sympathetic companion for this other person when they're sad, they've been broken up with, or they're in sort of like a painful love situation. But it feels like there's a lack of recognition on that person's part that maybe the narrator, the singer, you know, the sort of the protagonist of the song, really actually wants a connection between them, but always has to kind of play the fool, and always has to sort of like, you know, just, you know, deal with that person's emotional life and not really get to actually make the connection they're looking for. So it seems like maybe not three people per se, but like two people with the other person, not the second person, not realizing what the first person wants, and therefore the first person just kind of keeps suffering because they feel so strongly they want to be there for the other person, but, you know, at the cost of their own, like, emotional well-being. So let me know if I'm reading that wrong, but again, it's a real sort of like emotional ballad kind of tune, like I said, like a slow dance kind of song that, you know, even 10 years later when I was going to like school dances, it feels like that's one that would be played near the end of the evening. So in any case, we'll keep going through Freiheit. Again, I know, like, I'm going through so many different flavors of 80s music. Inevitably, like, you know, there's going to be some groups that certain people who are enjoying other deep vibes maybe aren't into. But as I mentioned to Seb, we're going to keep going with this one. So do let me know what you think about this. I will see you next time. Peace.